Lots of people talk about the different levels of BIM, but what do they actually mean? Well, the levels run from 0 to 3 and are used as measures of BIM maturity. That is, the construction supply chain's ability to operate and exchange information. Level 0 is essentially the use of computer-aided design or CAD tools to create drawings and drawn elements using IT software. It's the first step up from generating information by hand. By contrast, levels 1 to 3 deal with varying degrees of modelling, collaboration, and eventually the exchange of fully integrated interoperable data. Within level 1, we progress from CAD to generate suites of 2D information, followed by non-federated 3D models. Level 2 sees the progression to building information models and the federation of those models between different parties in the project team. Federation takes place within a single shared online area known as a common data environment. In broad terms, Level 2 is defined as file-based collaboration and library management, but we'll take a closer look at what that really means in a moment. Levels 1 and 2 are supported by various guidance documents available online. Level 3 envisages a wholly integrated product information model, hosted and fully developed in a common data environment by all members of the project team in real time. That model could then be passed to the employer for use in lifecycle management as an asset information model. We're still some way off that, and most AEC markets around the world remain firmly focused on the support, training and education required to achieve and hone our capabilities at Level 2. So what does Level 2 BIM mean, and how do you know when you've reached it? The exact definition is still evolving and hotly debated at industry level, so we're not offering a definitive answer here. There is, however, general consensus on the core principles. The first is that originators produce information in models which they control, sourcing from other models by reference, federation, or direct exchanges. These information models are developed using discipline-based software, proprietary databases, and varying degrees of interoperability. There should be an agreed process and protocol for digital information exchange. This might be grounded in guidance such as PAS 1192 Part 2. There'll also be clear employer's information requirements, or EIRs, either issued by the employer or developed by the service provider with the employer, using plain language questions to accurately interpret their needs. Each supplier's ability should be evaluated prior to contract award, and in this sense, supplier refers to all professional service providers in the project team. There'll be a BIM protocol, a BIM execution plan, and information exchanges will occur within that shared area we described earlier, known as the common data environment. All of those elements will result in the delivery of a coordinated graphical and non-graphical project information model to the employer for use in asset management. As we said a moment ago, while these represent core principles, the constituents of a Level 2 BIM project are still evolving, so do ensure that you keep up to date with the latest developments. The 0 to 3 levels of BIM maturity are different to the various dimensions of building information model data. In addition to 3D drawn information, attribute data can be included at 4D, 5D and 6D. 4D refers to time or project program information, 5D refers to cost data, and 6D to facilities management. The key thing here is that these are dimensions, not levels. All of these elements could be found within a Level 2 or Level 3 BIM model. This diagram was developed by Mark Bew and Mervyn Richards, and is hence known as the Bew-Richards BIM Maturity Model. Further information can be found within PAS 1192 Part 2, available from the British Standards website.